Animated bar charts is commonly used to show change in rankings over a period of time. This tutorial will show you how to create an animated bar chart in Google Data Studio for free without any coding. Welcome back, this is SL from Danalyser. In today's video, we'll be building a simple animated bar chart in Google Data Studio. We'll be learning how you can interact with the bar chart and how you can customize the bar chart so that you can change the speed of the animation or highlight certain values in the bar chart. If you are new to this tool, feel free to check out my free Google Data Studio course in my channel where you will learn how to build an interactive dashboard like this. So without further ado, let's get started. First of all, you will need to download the practice dataset from Kaggle. I'll leave the link in the description so you can download it. In case you want to use your own dataset in Microsoft Excel, do make sure that you export the data to CSV format first, then follow our next step. Once you have downloaded the file, upload it to Data Studio. Click Add Data, select the File Upload Connector, then click to upload the files. So here, we are going to select the file called issues.csv. Then you are going to wait until the file gets uploaded and the status is going to turn into green. Once it's done, you can click Add to add the data to our report. Then we'll need to add a community visualization called Animated Bar Chart because currently this animated bar chart race is not supported by Google Native Charts. So we're going to use community visualization to help us achieve that. So currently this component is being developed by Michael. So big thanks to Michael for this. To insert the chart, go to Community Gallery, then select the component you wish to add to the report. As this is an add-on component, you have to grant consent to allow this component to render data in your report. Then simply click to insert this chart to the canvas. Next, we'll be configuring the fields to generate the bar chart. In an animated bar chart, we will need two dimensions and one metric, which consists of a date field and a category, which is language in this case. And lastly, a metric, which is the number of issues on the repos. To add the fields, you just have to drag and drop them to these placeholders. Once the fields are added, we can already see the bars are start to move based on their rankings. Here, I just want to quickly talk about how you can interact with the bar chart race. At the bottom right of the chart, you will see two buttons. One is to stop the navigation whenever you find some interesting insights and you wish to stop it to analyze them further. Another button on the right is to change the granularity of the data aggregation. If you choose week, then the bars will show weekly movements, vice versa for days and months. Here, because the data we are using is already aggregated in years, so this wouldn't have any effect on our chart. You may also change the time aggregation using the property panel at the right. Finally, we'll be doing some customization for our chart. First, I'll show you how to change all the bar colors. We're going to click on this style tab in the property panel. Then click on the drop-down and select a color you like. Then the colors will be changed and reflected instantly on our chart. What if you only want to highlight a certain language? For example, maybe we are interested in comparing the popularity of Python and Java over time. So to make the comparison easier, we may want to highlight these two categories. You will just need to go to Style and under Highlighted Value, key in the value of the categories. If you wish to add more values, you can continue to add more, but remember to separate the categories using comma in between them. Note that no spacing is needed. Hit Enter after you have done adding the values and select a color for the highlight. You may also leave it as default, like what I did here. So now we have successfully highlighted two languages in this animated bar chart. Besides, you can also adjust the animation speed of the bar chart. So the greater value here means slower speed. You can play around with it and find the best speed for your chart. The usual chart that we have in the native bar chart, we can also add more categories into this. Right now, by default, it's 20 categories. We can just change the number to 30 if you want to include more categories into the animated bar chart. Other than that, we also have this option to fix the categories at its original position. By default, the bars with the highest value will always stay on top and the position of the categories will always be switching over time based on their relative rankings. However, if that's not what you want, you can turn off these settings and have the category fixed. And only the bars will be extending horizontally and contracting based on the metric value. Alright, I think we have covered pretty much everything about the animated bar chart today. Let me know what you think about this tutorial. If you have learned something useful, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.